Let us discuss another important aspect in the topic of elasticity, that is strain. For strain, we can say one applied forces, applied external forces we are talking about, applied forces on a body produce deformation, stresses develop inside the body. This we already studied in the previous section of stress, that when forces are applied, a deformation is produced, and restoring forces per unit area we define as stress. Now, due to stress, when we talk about the deformation, so we can say the relative change in dimensions of a body, or we can say relative change in shape of a body which is subjected to stress, is called strain. Strain is measured by a ratio of change in dimension to original dimension, like for a given body having a specific dimension D, and if an external force is applied, say two forces are applied on the two dimensions across the body, we can say due to which the dimension of body is shortened by a delta D. So we can say in this situation a strain can be defined as delta D by D. And this is because of the external forces the body is deforming, and internally restoring forces are developed. So body will get deformed up to the limit when restoring forces will exactly balance the external forces, deforming forces acting on body. So this is the way how we account the change in dimension of body, and this term we define as a strain. In general, for different type of cases, strain is given in three ways. We'll discuss in detail. One is a longitudinal strain, that is strain in length of a body due to normal stress. Other is a volume strain, when volume of a body changes by an external pressure or external force, then the change in volume is accounted in terms of volume strain. And the third one is shear strain, which is due to the shear stress applied within the body due to an external force. So we can say shear strain accounts for a tangential deformation of a body. So step by step we'll discuss about all these three kind of strain. Let's discuss one by one the three.